Hi everyone, it's Emmett from PiMyLifer. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up a Plex media server on a Raspberry Pi. Plex is a really neat piece of software that allows you to build a library of your own media and stream them to any connected device. Essentially with this software, you can create your own self-hosted Netflix. Before we get started with installing Plex onto your Raspberry Pi, there's one little caveat that you should be aware of. The modern Raspberry Pis are more than capable of streaming your media as long as it doesn't require transcoding. Transcoding is when Plex attempts to convert the file into something that the client understands. As long as the Plex client you're using is running on a somewhat modern device, this shouldn't be an issue in most cases. One codec that you will want to avoid is AV1. At the time of publishing, this codec is still classified as relatively new, meaning hardware doesn't properly support it in most cases. Additionally, the Raspberry Pi's relatively weak processor will really struggle to transcode this format. With that out of the way, we can now begin the process of installing the Plex media server onto our Raspberry Pi. Before we get anywhere, the first thing you'll want to do is set a static IP address for your Raspberry Pi. The best way to achieve this is through DHCP reservation on your router. However, you can also set it for your Raspberry Pi itself if you really wanted. We have a guide on this on our YouTube channel and on our website. I'll include a link below for anyone who's interested. Once you are ready, open the terminal on your Raspberry Pi or connect to it over SSH. Once you have access to the terminal, update the package list by typing in sudo apt update. Once the package list has been updated, we can upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing sudo apt upgrade-y. Upgrading all of these packages ensures that we have a nice updated base to work off of. Now that our Raspberry Pi is up to date, we need to ensure that the kernel package is installed to our system. To do this, type in sudo space apt space install space kernel space hyphen y. We'll be using this tool to download the GPG key for the Plex repository to our Raspberry Pi. A GPG key is basically a way of verifying that the packages are in fact coming from the correct place. This helps stop an attacker from swapping out the package with something malicious. To download this GPG key, type in kernel space https colon forward slash forward slash downloads.plex.tv slash plex hyphen keys slash plex sign dot key pipe symbol space gpg space hyphen hyphen darma space pipe symbol space sudo space t space slash user slash share slash keyring slash plex hyphen archive hyphen keyring dot gpg space greater than symbol slash dev slash null. Next, we need to add the Plex repository itself to our Raspberry Pi. We will do this by adding a line to a new sources.list file. This line will also reference the GPG key we just downloaded, so that it knows to use that GPG key to verify the contents of the Plex repository. Add this repository to your Raspberry Pi by typing echo space deb space open square bracket signed hyphen by equals slash user slash share slash keyring slash plex hyphen archive hyphen keyring dot gpg close square bracket, then type in https colon symbol slash slash downloads dot plex dot tv slash repo slash dev space public space main followed by the pipe symbol, then sudo space t space slash etc slash apt slash sources dot list dot d slash plex media server dot list. Since we added a new package repository, we will need to run an update of the package list again. You can update the package list by typing sudo apt update into the terminal. From the result of this command, you should now see that there are three references to the Plex repository. In particular, you should notice that it is referencing both the ARM64 and ARMHF packages of Plex. If you're running a 32-bit operating system on your Raspberry Pi, you may only just see ARMHF. We can now install the Plex media server to your Raspberry Pi by typing in sudo space apt space install space plex media server space hyphen y. Once this media streaming server has been installed, it'll give you a quick rundown of what it did. This includes the Plex user and group that it has automatically set itself up with. This user is also the one that will need permissions to access your media files. If you haven't already done so, now is a good time to mount your media files to your Raspberry Pi. Two of the best ways to do this is to either use a network detached storage device or by connecting a USB hard drive. For this guide, we have already mounted a network drive to /mount/media. This drive contains some movies from the Blender Open Movies project. Make a note of where your media is mounted, as we will need this directory for the next step. Essentially, what we are going to want to do is adjust some permissions to help reduce the chance of Plex not being able to read your media. To do this, we want to elevate to the super user by typing in sudo space su. You will know you are running as a root user now, as the user on the left-hand side will now be shown as root instead of your username. Now, to change permissions, we'll be making use of the find command's exec functionality. By using this, you'll be able to individually adjust both directory and files permissions. Begin adjusting directory permissions by typing in find space, followed by the path to where your media is mounted, which in our case is /mount/media, followed by space hyphen type space d space hyphen exec space chip mod space 755, open curly bracket, close curly bracket, space slash, and then a semicolon. By changing the permission to 755 for the directory, it allows our Plex user to be able to read and execute this directory, but not be able to alter it. Next, we want to do the same thing, but for files. To do this, type in find space, followed by the directory where your media is mounted, followed by space, hyphen type, space F, space hyphen, exec, space chip mod, space 644, space open curly bracket, close curly bracket, space slash, and then a semicolon. The main difference between these two commands is that for files, we are setting the permissions 644. This will ensure that our Plex user will be able to read the files within this directory, but it won't be able to edit or execute these files. Now that we have finished adjusting the permissions for these media files so that Plex can access them, we can now exit out of the super user by typing exit into the command line and pressing enter. You can verify that you're now running as your normal user, as the line should start with a username instead of root. We can finally finish setting up Plex on our Raspberry Pi by accessing its web interface. If you have forgotten what your IP address is, you can type in hostname space hyphen capital I to print out the assigned IP addresses. In our example, you can see that our IP address is 192.168.0.32. With your IP address in hand, open your favorite web browser and go to the following address: http://, followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi, which in our case is 192.168.0.32. Follow this up with the colon symbol and then the port number 32400, then /web/. Plex will now ask you to either log in or create a Plex account. There are various advantages to using a Plex account, but not everyone will want to be forced to use one. If you're one of those people, you can actually still use Plex without creating an account. To avoid creating an account, click the What's This text at the bottom of the screen. This will give you a warning about some of the functionality that you're going to miss out on by not using a Plex account. If you're happy to proceed with this, click the Skip and Accept Limited Functionality link. However, if you are like us and already have a Plex account, you can just click the Sign In button and follow the prompts. We can now finally finish setting up Plex. To begin this process, click the Got It button at the bottom of the screen. On this first screen, you'll be asked to give a friendly name to your server so that you can identify it through the Plex apps. In our case, we'll be renaming ours to Pi Plex Server. On the same screen, you can also decide whether you want outside access to your Plex server. Please note, for this functionality to actually work, you will need to open port 32400 on your router. Once you're happy to proceed, click the next button. We can now begin to add our media libraries to Plex. To begin this process, click the Add Library button. You'll now see a list of the different library types that Plex supports. Select the library type for the media that you are adding. In our example, we are adding movies, so we selected the movies type. With this, you can also set a name for this library, as well as select the language. Once you are ready to begin setting up this library, click the next button. On this next screen, you want to click the Browse for Media folder button. Now navigate to where your media is stored. In our case, this will be /mount/media/movies. Once you have the directory selected, click the Add button to add it to your library. You can add multiple folders to a single library, but for our case, we are just going to proceed with the setup by clicking the Add Library button. You can continue to use this screen to add multiple different libraries to your Plex Media server. You don't have to set up everything now, as it is possible to add additional libraries later on. Once you are ready, click the Next button to finish with the installation of Plex to your Raspberry Pi. This next screen just tells you about the various Plex apps you can use to access your media. Click the Done button to proceed to the Plex web interface. At this point, you have successfully set up the Plex Media server on your Raspberry Pi. You'll find your media libraries are referenced within the left-hand sidebar. For our example, let's open up our movies library. With this screen, you can see Plex has automatically pulled metadata for our free movies. This includes the cover data as well as the year that it was published. To show our Raspberry Pi Plex server in action, let's hit the play button on the Syntel movie. You can see that our Raspberry Pi is effortlessly streaming this media straight to our web browser. This software has allowed us to easily set up our own low-powered media server. If you like this tutorial, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.